गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू नेक्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ इकॉन 242, दैट इज एग्रीकल्चरल फाइनेंस एंड कोऑपरेशन। इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन अबाउट द कोऑपरेशन एंड प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ कोऑपरेशन। सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंडियन कोऑपरेटिव मूवमेंट। So, in history of cooperative movement in India, as we know, Robert Owen, 1771 to 1858, is considered to be the father of cooperative movement. Means at a global level, Robert Owen is considered the father of the cooperative movement. Now, the history of Indian cooperative movement is divided in two part, that is the cooperative movement during pre-independence period, means during 1948, and cooperative movement during post-independence period. So if we think about the cooperative movement during pre-independence period, if you look back into the history of the cooperative movement in the India, the first Cooperative Society Act was passed in 1904. First Cooperative Societies Act was passed in India in 1904. Okay, so the scope of the act was restricted to the establishment of primary credit societies and non-credit societies were left out its purview. Means in the 1904, first Cooperative Societies Act was passed, and this act was restricted to the establishment of primary credit societies and non-credit societies were left out of its purview or out of its region. Then the shortcomings of the act of 1904 were corrected by enacting another Cooperative Societies Act in 1912. Means there are some limitations or there are some lacunas in the act of 1904. So these lacunas or these shortcomings of act 1904 were corrected by the enacting or forcing another Cooperative Societies Act in 1912. So this act gave provision for the registration of all types of cooperatives. Means the act of 1912 gave the provision for the registration of all types of cooperative societies. Then this made the emergence of rural cooperative both on credit front and non-credit front, but their growth was uneven spatially. Means because of the act of 1912, the emergence need of rural cooperatives both on credit front and non-credit front, but the growth was uneven spatially. Means the act of 1912, they have fulfilled the rural cooperative credit need, but their growth was the uneven spatially. This led to appointment of Sir Edward McLagan committee in 1914 to review the performance of the societies. Means because of this uneven growth, this uneven growth leads to appointment of the new committee under the chairmanship of Sir Edward McLagan in 1914 to review the performance of various societies. The committee came out with a report that true cooperative spirit was lacking in respect of majority of societies and hence recommended for limited area of operation for each society. Means there are some societies which are not maintaining the true cooperative spirit in their operation. So in respect of majority of societies, hence the committee of Sir Edward McLagan recommended for limited area of operation for each society. Then the Indian Central Banking Inquiry Committee in 1931. Indian Central Banking Inquiry Committee in 1931 also highlighted the obvious gap, particularly with reference to undue delays and inadequacy of credit. So, next, so again, another committee, Professor D.R. Gadgil, heading the Agriculture Finance Subcommittee appointed by the Government of India, recommended in 1944, the adoption of limited liability to the cooperatives, assessing credit worthiness based on repayment capacity of the farmer, subsidizing the cost of administration of small cooperative societies, linking of credit with marketing, etc., for improving the cooperative financial aspects. Means, if you observe, there are so many committees which are before pre-independence era, during pre-independence era period, they have also given some recommendation. Means, first you just keep in mind the first Cooperative Act 1904, then this Act of 1904 was corrected in the Act of 1912, then this 1912 Act, there are some lacunas in that Act also, then it is also reviewed by the Edward McLagan Committee in 1914, then 1931, and in 1944, under the chairmanship of D.R. Gadgil, they have given some recommendations for the operation of the cooperatives, like assessing credit worthiness based on the repayment capacity of farmer, then subsidizing the cost of administration of small cooperative societies, linking the credit with marketing, etc. All these steps are taken for improving the cooperative financial aspects. So, this is about the history of cooperatives in pre-independence period. Now, the progress of cooperative movement during post-independence period. Now, the All India Rural Credit Survey Committee, appointed by the RBI, Reserve Banks of India, in 1951, under the chairmanship of Sri A.D. Gorwala. So, keep in mind, All India Rural Credit Survey Committee, appointed by RBI in 1951, under the chairmanship of Sri A.D. Gorwala, brought out that the cooperative credit was unevenly distributed, inadequate, and mostly lent to the asset-oriented large cultivator. Means, here, in 1951, the Committee of Reserve Bank of India, under the chairmanship of A.D. Gorwala, they brought out some findings. They found that cooperative credit was unevenly distributed among the farmers or among the members, and inadequate, and mostly lent to or mostly given to the asset-oriented large cultivators. Means, large farmers, they are getting the advantage of cooperative credit. So, here they are neglecting the small and marginal farmers. So, it is seen by or it is found by the Sri A.D. Gorwala Committee. The report observes that cooperation has failed in India but must succeed. Means, according to Gorwala Committee, the cooperation has failed in India but it must be succeed. So, the committee recommended an integrated scheme as a remedy to existing situation, the silent features, which are, means that committee, they have recommended some solutions over such a problem. They are integrated scheme as a remedy to existing situation. Now, firstly, they said that state partnership in cooperative institution at all levels, means they are attaching the state government with the cooperative institutions at all the levels. Then, coordination between cooperative credit, marketing and processing societies, means they want the cooperation or connection between the cooperative credit societies, cooperative marketing societies and cooperative processing society. Then third recommendation, training of cooperative personnels at all levels. Means there is need of training to the staff of the cooperative societies at all the levels. So these are the recommendation, or these are the remedies to overcome the existing situation recommended by the Sri A.D. Gorwala committee in 1951. Now later, the Committee on Takavi Loan, the Committee on Takavi Loan and Cooperative Credit under the chairmanship of Sri B.P. Patel in 1961-62 felt that, or they found that cooperative should provide loans to the farmer for the agricultural operations and land improvements, and takavi loan should be confined to the farmers only under distressed conditions. As we have seen, in 1951, A.D. Gorwala also found that some large farmers, only large farmers or asset oriented large cultivators, they are getting the advantage of cooperative credit. Here the same thing, Sri B.P. Patel, they felt that cooperative should provide a loan to the farmer for the agricultural operations and land improvement, and particularly for takavi loan should be given to the farmers only under distress conditions. Okay, so regarding the supervision of societies at a grassroots level, primary cooperative credit societies, the Committee on Cooperative Administration under the chairmanship of Sri V.L. Mehta appointed that district cooperative bank should assume this responsibility. Means after 1962, regarding the supervision of this, regarding the supervision or control on the cooperative societies at grassroots level or at ground root level, the PACs, means primary cooperative credit societies, the Committee on Cooperative Administration under the chairmanship of V.L. Mehta appointed that the district cooperative bank should assume this responsibility. Means district cooperative societies, district cooperative bank, DCCB, should take the responsibility of controlling or supervising the cooperatives at the grassroots level or at the village level in their particular area, according to the recommendation of Sri V.L. Mehta. Then the All India Rural Credit Review Committee, that is AICRC, which was constituted in July 1966 under the chairmanship of B. Venkatapaya, in its final report submitted in July 1969, recommended that, means the All India Rural Credit Review Committee, which is constituted in 1966 under the chairmanship of Sri B. Venkatapaya, in its final report, they have submitted their report in July 1969. So they recommended that reorganization of primary societies into viable units. Means Sri Venkatapaya recommended there should be need of reorganization of primary societies into viable units, rehabilitation of weaker central cooperative banks, greater flexibility in the conversion of short-term loans into medium-term loans, conversion of short-term loan into medium-term loan, simplification of application from disturbable of part of the loan in a kind, means distribution of the part of loan in the kinds or in the kinds of inputs also. These are the some recommendations given by the Sri Venkatapaya in its final report, which was submitted in July 1969. So sooner after the independence, the government of India, following the recommendations of All India Rural Credit Survey Committee 1951, felt that cooperative were the only alternative to promote the agricultural credit and development of rural area. Means according to the report of AICRC, All India Rural Credit Survey Committee, sorry, ऑल इंडिया रूरल क्रेडिट सर्वे कमिटी फेल्ड दैट कोऑपरेटिव इज द ओनली वे टू डेवलप द रूरल क्रेडिट सिस्टम इन टू द एट द ग्रास रूट लेवल. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू कोऑपरेटिव रिसीव्ड सब्सटेशनल हेल्प और गुड हेल्प इन प्रोविजन ऑफ क्रेडिट फ्रॉम द रिजर्व बैंक ऑफ इंडिया एज अ पार्ट ऑफ लोन पॉलिसी एंड लार्ज स्केल असिस्टेंस एंड इनकरेजमेंट फ्रॉम द सेंट्रल एंड स्टेट गवर्नमेंट फॉर देयर डेवलपमेंट. मीन्स एट दैट टाइम देयर वॉज फुल सपोर्ट फ्रॉम द सेंट्रल बैंक ऑफ इंडिया, दैट इज RBI, रिजर्व बैंक ऑफ इंडिया एंड स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स फॉर देयर डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द कोऑपरेटिव क्रेडिट इन द रूरल एरिया. मेनी स्कीम्स ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट विथ components of subsidies and concessions to the weaker section were routed through the cooperatives. Means there are so many schemes, policies or some subsidies, concessions given by the government of India to the weaker sections, but they are routed or they are distributed through the cooperatives. As a result, cooperative institutions registered remarkable progress in the post-independence area. So this is about the history of cooperative movement in India in pre-independence period and post-independence period. Now you can refer the book of Agriculture, Finance and Management, Subba Reddy, Raghuram, and another common book is Agricultural Economics by Subba Reddy. Keep watching my videos. Try to share these videos with the maximum students. Thank you.